and Sarah Daniels.
Yipping and yapping.
Philip Dubalon here, host of Urban Suburban. And the two of you, I'm going to start with you, Phil.
Yes.
Home show this weekend.
Home show.
Where are you going to be? What can we see? What are you doing?
We're on the HDTV main stage tonight at 6 o'clock, and then on Saturday, same performance, noon and 7. We're like a comedy routine.
We're opening for Brian Baumler.
Yes.
Oh. We're very excited. This is what's happening on Saturday. We're on at noon, and he's on at 1. So we're going to basically ask the audience, how many people got here earlier to save their seat? Because Brian is huge with the ladies.
Yes.
Really?
Huge with the ladies.
Philip, he does quite well himself, though, with the ladies.
Not really.
I'm married.
But that's okay.
And I love my wife.
Married with children.
Married with kids.
Yes.
Three.
I know.
Wow.
Who would have imagined way back in the day?
Who would have imagined?
Because we all go way back. Way back. We were the Cruiser Chicks.
Yeah, exactly.
Rock 101 back in the day. Oh, unbelievable. And then we were talking about morning show duties. You've done this early morning.
I did this for 8 years. So
Eight wonderful years.
Eight fabulous years. Yeah, no, but wow. Yeah.
Making the jump to real estate.
Real estate, that's a little bit easier. Longer hours, but a little bit easier on the sleep schedule, that's for sure.
It is. So what have you guys noticed with the trends? I mean, real estate's always a hot topic this part of the country. Is it a buyer's market? Is it a seller's market? What are the trends you're seeing?
It's kind of a in-between market right now. It's trying to sort itself out. And I think people are going back to, I've been working with some buyers for 9 months, and they've all been waiting for that proverbial shoe to drop with pricing. And it obviously hasn't happened. So now they're starting to enter back into the market, and I think prices are starting to settle, and I think we're going to see more of a balanced market here in the next few months.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, in condo market, townhouse market, in certain areas too, they're a little bit overbuilt, obviously, because there's a lot of stuff on the market. So you're always going to probably have a little bit more flexibility buying in that kind of market. So it's more of a buyer's market there. But as far as single family homes are concerned, I'm seeing less come on the market. I mean, every day I look at the hot sheet that we get in our various areas, and there's a lot of stuff at the very high end. There's a lot of stuff in the lower end, but in the middle, where a lot of people are, there's not a lot of inventory. Yeah. Sorry.
I've only got the experience with Toronto markets when it came to buying houses, other than you taking care of me here.
Yeah.
In Vancouver, advice to the homeowner sitting right now going, I need to list my house. Mm-hmm. It's a great house. Mm-hmm. I think I can get this for it. Do you go on the market at the biggest number possible, or do you attract more? Give.
Well, it's pretty simple. First of all, you call me.
Right.
Okay. Secondly,
here we go.
Step one.
Yep.
But the interesting thing is we have to get them out of that DeLorean. It is not 2011 anymore. The time machine of real estate pricing, it is 2013. Prices have softened a little bit, so it's getting your seller to be realistic. And what is their motivation? Do they really want to move? We're trying to get people back to, I have three kids. We've got another one on the way. We're moving because we need a bigger house. Those days of just renovating a bathroom and a kitchen and expecting to make an additional $150,000, $200,000, those days are long gone. So the speculators are going to be gone, which will be good, and I think we'll just get back to regular trading of real estate.
Yeah, I think there was such a glut on the market, particularly last year. I mean, people really wanted to. 2011 was a really big year. So 2012, people are, I'm going to put my house on the market. I'm going to add 10, 15%. A lot of those people did not need to move. So you saw a whole ton of inventory out there. And, you know, perhaps the same amount of buyers, probably a little bit less. But when you've got that much to choose from, and you're not really forced to make a decision, you know, people were quite fine with going around and lowballing, and that's what affected the market. Now, I remember at some point last year, I think it was by the end of August in last year, North Vancouver, West Vancouver, I believe it was West Van in particular, they had over 900 listings on the market. That's way, way past the normal amount of inventory you'd have there. And 60 of those were over $5 million. So, you know, a lot of those people were thinking, okay, well, I'm going to take advantage of overseas buyers. I'm going to take advantage of this, that, the next thing. I'll put my house on the market at a really, you know, crazy price. If somebody buys it, it's great. But if they don't, well, I'll take it off the market. Well, you flood the market, invariably you push down the prices.
What are you looking at for prospective buyers? Downtown condos, we're hearing about a lot of supply. Average price per square foot, what's a good benchmark that people should look at?
Oh God, it's all over the map. It really depends on the building.
It varies,
you know,
obviously.
I mean, some buildings are, you know, if you're buying in a building that you're buying as an investment where there's no rental restrictions, you're probably going to pay a little bit less per square foot because those buildings have a constant influx of tenants. The hallways tend to not look as great. You might be a little bit more prone to break-ins. There's not as many owners living in the building, right? So there might not be that sort of pride of ownership that you might see in a building that has more stringent rent restrictions. So it really depends on, you know, the street location, whereabouts are you downtown. Like some blocks are great, some others are not really so great at all.
Anywhere from 400 to over 1,000 a square foot.
Yeah, really
can look
depends.
At.
What floor level you are, you know, I mean, if you're on the second floor, you're going to be lower per square foot. If you're a penthouse, you know.
So if you're sitting in your property,
yes,
and you're wondering, I wonder how much this is worth today,
yes,
in 2013, not
right,
looking online and here's what it was in 2011, whatever,
yes,
here's what everything else is going for, because it can give you an inflated idea of what mm-hmm. your property. Do you call you first, or do you call somebody who whose job it is to assess?
No. I mean,
really what you want to do, yeah, call your realtor who, or whoever you've been working with and get the latest sales data within the last 3 months of your area.
3 months.
That's going to give you some very good relevant data as to what your home is worth.
And remove
your personal tastes
yeah.
from the equation.
That's
because
the
what
big
you
one.
Like may
yeah.
not be what the masses
yeah,
like.
Yeah, it's got to be in your area, and don't start comparing your, if you live in a rancher, which is quite desirable, or a two-level home, don't compare yourself to a split entry, which doesn't tend to do as well price-wise. You have to compare your property to what other comparable style of homes are going for, not just based on square footage.
Right.
It's got to take into account lot size, whether you're on a busy street. So, you know, basically take the blinders off. Be realistic.
Don't have a price in your head and then call the realtor.
And
call the realtor and then get
Philip
the price.
One thing, Philip and I, it drives you crazy. Well, I need to get from... Nobody
yeah.
cares what you need to get, sadly.
It's
what it's worth.
It's what it's
the buyers
worth.
Are going to... Buyers aren't going to go, well, it's, you know, you want $700,000. It's worth $625,000, but I want to make you happy. Have you ever heard of that? I want those people. If you know, it just doesn't make any sense, right? So.
We'll tell you what, more tips from these two at the BC Home and Garden Show. We'll put details on our Facebook page. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for having
pleasure.
Good to see you both. All right, there's the website for more information. Russ LeCate, standing by. Let's look at weather.
I think my neighbors in Surrey need to call Philip and Sarah because my values softened on my assessment, and all the listings that went up around the neighborhood are about 30% higher than last year. Crazy. I think people are looking to cash in big time. Absolutely.